Can any of you guess what those are used for? Well, I've been tidying, and you see, it's a bit of fun here, but let me show you what I've got going on here. So, a little tidier for you, finally. So one of the problems I've got is lots of spools of thread, and I tidied yesterday and realized this is not going to work, because those threads won't last forever, they get unsticky. However, there you go. There's that. This also, you can put a bobbin on top to keep bobbins of the same color together. But also, the small ones go on spools of thread. So I'll try and do this single-handedly. What you can see here is a little difficult with one hand, but to go. It's hard to see black on green here, folks. Too difficult with one hand. However, what you can see in there is some of my spools of thread with those little rings on them. And the small rings are when the thread spool gets different shafts, widths, and different amounts of thread. So the small ones are when there's less thread. Now, the only one I haven't designed yet is for my Davis long bobbins, but because this is too thick for long bobbins, so I'm going to come up with an alternative for the long bobbins. But I will do that. Anyway, if you're wondering what that big one's for, the answer is that. Great, huh? So I finally have a way of tidying all my large spools, of which I have lots, and you can see the tape that I put on yesterday is awfully peeling off, so that's why I have to print lots of those. And as you go through thread, it gets smaller, so therefore you have to use a smaller ring when they're full. I was going to think of using my Dremel to cut a little slice in there, and then I could wrap the thread, but the hooks work fine. If you want to know how I get those, see some large ring and bobbin ring making out there. So I'll continue working on my design. Well, I decided I needed to make sure my long bobbins had a home as well. So there you go. Enough for 15. I only have 12. But that's fine. So a bit of improvement over the top cover would be in order, just to make it easier to put them back on. But gravity is the friend, so it's not terrible, but I need to refine this a bit. Or I just put this in a bag. But it's a bit fiddly to put the top cover on because the bobbins don't want to sit. I probably could have made it longer, but it doesn't really make much of a difference, because then I wouldn't be able to see the bobbin. So I could have probably made it up to there. Might consider it. But I need to be able to get in there to pull them out, so I thought leaving a bit of length was good. So it's a bit fiddly, maybe sponge inside or something. But it's doable with two hands, and it works. Options, but, you know, work in progress, but for first go, just creating this thing. So it's basically a bunch of hollow tubes with an end. And I put them together and then printed them. Printed two, and that's the way it works. So anyway, it's doable. I'm quite pleased. I've got a bobbin cover for these as well. And then the threads won't get so tangled. Anyway, bye for now.